Hey, boys and girls, you're here. Oh, I'm so glad that you tuned in. We're going to have a great Sabbath school again today. We're going to learn about a man named
Nicodemus.
Yeah, Nicodemus. And oh, it's going to be a great story. But as we get started, why don't we have a word of prayer and we'll have a great Sabbath school. Let's pray. Lord in heaven, thank you so much for another wonderful Sabbath morning. We thank you, Father, for loving us like you do. We learned about that last week. And now, Father, we pray that you'll teach us some very, very important lessons, more lessons about love. And we thank you for this time that we can share. And we pray that you'll be with us. And we pray that in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
What are we going to study about or do next, Miss Julie?
Okay, well, our memory verse today is found in Proverbs 17:17. Shall we say it together?
All right.
A friend loves at all times. Proverbs 17:17. You want to say it together again? A friend loves at all times. Proverbs 17:17. Well, like Pastor Joe told you, our story today is going to be about a man named Nicodemus who met Jesus when he was an adult, and it happened right before Jesus died on the cross. But Nicodemus learned to love Jesus and felt that Jesus was his special friend. And Jesus is our special friend too, right, Pastor Joe?
Yeah, that's right. That's right. So we're going to learn a lot about loving each other because Jesus loves us. All right. Well, what's this song we're going to do?
Well, actually, this is called a scripture song. It comes right out of the Bible, although we made it a little bit more friendly English for you than how we learned it from the King James. It is found in 1 John 4, 7 and 8, and that's what we're going to say at the end. Okay, I wrote out first so you know to say 1 John 4, 7 and 8. Okay, so let's try it. All right, here we go.
Here we go. Okay, here it goes. Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God, and everyone that loves belongs to God and knows God. He that loves not doesn't know God, for God is love. So beloved, let us love one another. 1 John 4, 7 and 8.
Should we try it again, boys
okay,
and girls?
Okay, here we go.
All right, Pastor Joe.
Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God, and everyone that loves belongs to God and knows God. He that loves not doesn't know God, for God is love. So beloved, let us love one another. 1 John 4, 7 and 8.
Okay, hopefully hey, you'll fun. Remember that song, and you can look it up in your Bible too. 1 John 4, 7 and 8.
All right. Okay, I think it's time to get started with Sabbath school. So we're going to get out of here and we'll see you on the other side. And I hope that you have a great time. Bye, everybody.
Bye, boys and girls.
And so I'm going to change how I'm holding these. Really heavy, right? It's heavier than you expected. It's not that big, right? You want to feel that? It's really heavy. You want to hold? I'm going to help you build it because it's very heavy. Want to feel how heavy? Heavy? Really, I'm going to help you hold it because it's really heavy. All right, so I'm going to hold. Oh, did you not pick it? So it's really, really heavy. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to try when I'm spinning, holding these out. It's really heavy, to be fair. It's heavier than you think. This is like 10 pounds. Heavy, right? I'm going to try to. How heavy do you think it is? I think it's closer to at least 10 or 12, right? Okay, so I'm going to try when I'm spinning, holding these out, and then I'm going to pull them in, close to my heart, right? Closer in. And you guys are going to watch how I change how I spin. Okay, are we ready?
All right.
Ready? Inside, outside, inside, outside.
Oh, cool.
I'm dizzy. I know. Pay attention to how fast,
baby.
Faster. In, out, in, out, and in. and I didn't fall over, but I might need to sit down.
Okay, so why is that? So God has put into the universe a special law, and that law is called conservation of angular momentum. It's very cool. It comes from all these space-time symmetries and all that goodness, but the idea is that there's a certain amount of spin that one body has, in this case her, and that has to be conserved. And it depends on how massive you are and where those masses are located. So if she's carrying these heavy weights, out here, she has a certain amount of momentum. When she pulls them in, she has the same amount of momentum, but since they're closer to her heart, she has to move faster to compensate. That's kind of a cool little physics thing.
Okay, so this reminds me of where we sometimes keep God, right? So sometimes we let everything in our life take the center, right, close to our heart. So when I was holding them inside, was I faster or was I slower?
Faster,
much faster when I held them in here, right? If I held them out here, I slowed down, right? So sometimes we let everything else in our life take the center, and we keep God at a distance, way out here, right? These really heavy weights at a distance. And that's hard to hold them out there, too. And so we make other things the center of our lives, but we have to keep Jesus near our hearts in order to keep the motion in our lives that he planned for us. And so things are just harder when he's not at our center. It's harder to spin in the chair. When I'm holding these heavy weights out here, I have to keep them close to my heart. So James 4:8 says, draw near to God and he will draw near to you. And so you always have to keep him at the center of your heart.
Many kids, getting to school might mean riding a school bus or driving across town in your car. But could you imagine going to a school in another state or even another country? Maria lives in northern Namibia on the continent of Africa. But she goes to school in another country. All of the schools in her town are full, so she has to travel a few miles to the Santa Clara Adventist School. Even though the school was not far from her house, it was in Angola, which is a completely different country. Each day, Maria crosses the border from Namibia to Angola to go to school. Sometimes her father can drive her, but most of the time she walks. Maria is grateful to have a place to learn, but the Santa Clara school wasn't perfect. There are nice teachers and students, but there weren't enough classrooms. Most of the students met for classes under trees. There were no desks, and kids had to bring chairs from home to have a place to sit. Andre Guerrera is in the fourth grade at the Santa Clara Adventist School. He likes coming to school, but learning under trees is difficult.
I don't like to go to school under the trees because when the rain comes, I get wet and I get a fever.
Can you imagine trying to study under a tree? Besides the sun and rain, it's hard to listen to the teacher because there is lots of noise from other classes and cars that drive by. When we heard about the kids in Santa Clara, Maranatha wanted to help. So we built a brand new school campus. Now Maria and Andre are learning in bright new classrooms. Students no longer have to study under trees, in the rain, or in the sun. Maria is excited about the new classrooms, but even more excited about what she's learning each day.
It's a new experience that I have here. And being here at this school, I not only learn things from school, but also things about God.
Now, with the help of Maranatha, hundreds of kids have new classrooms, places to learn about Jesus.
Story today. It's very meaningful. Do you have a special friend? What do you do with your special friends? Did you know that Jesus had a special friend? His name was Nicodemus. I'm going to tell you a little story. So Nicodemus was peeking through his door and it was nighttime. And he said, I am going to find Jesus. I want to talk to him. He had studied his Bible and he was sure that Jesus was the Messiah that was supposed to come and save his people. So he walked out the door. It was dark outside and he walked past the gate. And past the gate, he was thinking in his head, I know that Jesus is a good man, that I believe he's the Messiah, that he's not just a teacher. But Nicodemus had very important friends. He was an important man, and his friends didn't like Jesus' healing, or they didn't like that Jesus was teaching and that he wasn't someone that had learned in a special school. So they were afraid that people would follow Jesus instead of them. Nicodemus wanted to talk to Jesus more and more to learn a little bit more about him and decided he finally found him. He walked and walked and he finally found him. He said, I know. When he found Jesus, he said, Jesus, I know that you are a teacher from God. And no one else can do the miracles you do. And no one else has such profound teachings. And you know, Jesus
spoke very kindly to Nicodemus.
He said, you know, God loves everybody. And Nicodemus said, that God has sent someone very special. He's going to send someone very special to tell them about me. Tell them not about me, but about my Father, God in heaven. So after he talked to Jesus, he was convinced. He knew that Jesus was very special. And he knew that the Bible scrolls that he was reading convinced him that he was the Messiah and he was the Savior of the world that God had promised to send. However, Nicodemus had a problem. His important friends did not like Jesus. So Jesus said that They needed a new heart, a loving heart for other people, more than just following the rules without love and kindness. Later, when Jesus
actually died on the cross,
did you know Nicodemus was there to help him? They helped him. He didn't care if his important neighbors and his friends knew that he loved Jesus. He wanted everyone to know about Jesus. Now, Nicodemus was a very rich man. And you know what? He started spending all of his money on
helping people
and teaching them.
His friendship with Jesus
changed his heart, and he wanted to help other people. You know, everybody should know about Jesus, right?
It changes our hearts.
Nicodemus wanted other people to know about him, and we want other people to know about him too, don't we? Did you know Jesus can be your special friend?
And he can be in your heart? I want Jesus
in my heart. I want him as my special friend, don't you? Let's ask Jesus right now. Let's pray. Jesus,
will you be our special
friend? Will you make our heart loving and soft and kind to others? Help us to listen to you
and do the things that you put into our hearts. We love you, and we want you in our hearts, and we want to tell everyone about you. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Thank you for listening to that story. Have a good Sabbath. Bye now.
Well, it looks like we had a great time, just like we had hoped. So I hope that you remember all of the important lessons that we learned and take it with you through the week that's coming. And remember, we need to love one another in every way we can think of. All right? Have a great time. Oh, I think we need to have our closing prayer.
Yeah, why don't we pray, boys and girls? Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this absolutely wonderful Sabbath day. Thank you for all the boys and girls, their moms and dads. Thank you for Jesus, our special friend. Help us to always be special friends to other people too, just like Jesus was. And Lord, as Pastor Joe said, help us to love one another because you are love. We praise you and we thank you in the name of Jesus, our Savior.
Amen.
All right, boys and girls.
Bye, guys.
Have a wonderful Sabbath.